In May of 2001, nearly 6 months before the release of Windows XP, Microsoft began working on another version of Windows. But not a whole lot was known about it. However, one thing was certain. It was going to be the most ambitious upgrade that the Windows platform had ever seen, and would set the standard for personal computing in the 21st century. Microsoft simply called it Longhorn. The fact that Microsoft was already in the development stages of this product before XP even hit store shelves was a testament to their determination to keep going forward. With glossy, reflective textures and interactive buttons, it was going to be the flagship operating system that would blur the line between the digital and real world. Among computer enthusiasts, it quickly became one of the most hyped up and anticipated launches of its time. But for whatever reason, that time never came. Nearly 4 years into the making, Microsoft completely scrapped the Longhorn project, which left many eager users scratching their heads. Around 2 years after, Microsoft would instead release Windows Vista, which would be met with incredibly negative reviews. It just felt like a half-baked version of what they were promised. Aside from some rather underground leaks, Longhorn never actually saw the light of day, and if it weren't for those leaks, the project itself likely would have remained a complete mystery, lost to innovation, as well as lost to time. While this forgotten product never came to fruition, it did serve as a great learning lesson for Microsoft, and was very indicative of the world's desire to strive towards the future, beyond technological limitations. So what happened to Longhorn? Was its demise the result of bad planning, or was it simply too ahead of its time? Now, I have dabbled into Longhorn's history on my channel in the past, but more as a jumping-off point to contextualize why Windows Vista was so lackluster compared to something like XP, despite being 5 years newer and looking so much sleeker. Because even in 2006, Windows XP already looked very outdated, and Microsoft knew that this was going to happen, even way back in 2001. In fact, it could be argued that this was one of the big causes of Longhorn's downfall, as it would create a sort of domino effect that would create many other problems within its development. This included overambition, which would then lead to lack of direction, security problems, and of course, losing touch with the product's target audience. You have to remember that computers were just so damn competitive in the 90s, and this only got more intense by the millennium because of how rapidly they were advancing. With this technological change came a cultural change, and it appeared in the form of computer graphics. To really capture the idea of the future, computers made the most out of their capabilities by ditching the more monotone, flat look of their programs and embraced this more inviting, bubbly, and realistic look. It has retrospectively been called Frutiger Arrow, but the look was largely popularized in 2001 with the release of Mac OS X and their new UI advertised as Aqua. This came out only about 6 months before XP, which didn't give Microsoft much time to one-up Apple in this regard. Did they necessarily need to do this? Well, no. Windows was already beating Mac OS in market share significantly, but with Apple's comeback with the iMac in 1998 and this revolutionary software design, they were showing lots of potential and getting caught up. It was intimidating. Microsoft even experimented with the Aqua design a little bit, which subsequently became an Easter egg in XP, but it wasn't enough time for them to properly implement it. They now had to get started on the next version of Windows that would completely blow Aqua out of the water. See what I did there? So right after the release of XP, Microsoft announced to the public that they were working on their next project, codenamed Longhorn. Now, this ambitious Windows project we just talked about? Well, Longhorn wasn't supposed to be it. You see, this was instead going to be reserved for a project codenamed Windows Black Home, which was scheduled for release just a year later in 2002. You're probably thinking, releasing a whole new version of Windows just a little under a year after releasing XP seems like a lot, and it was. But you must understand, this was also coming from a place of trying to keep up with the rapid changes computers were undergoing at this time. It was the choice that made the most sense for Microsoft at that point. But it quickly became clear that what they had in mind for the operating system was certainly going to take a long time to put all together. And so, Microsoft pushed the development of Black Home back by another year. To keep the Windows name somewhat fresh, they decided to create a more incremental release in the meantime. which was, of course, Longhorn. Microsoft's choices for these codenames were very on-the-nose metaphors for what they intended Windows to become. Windows XP had the codename Whistler, which is the name of a mountain in British Columbia, Canada. Blackcomb is the name of another mountain nearby, and there's even a ski resort that connects the two. Longhorn is the name of a bar and grill between both of them, and you have to pass it in order to take Whistler to Blackcomb. Microsoft felt that it would be fitting to give Windows the same vision. This vision, however, would be short-lived, because as soon as they started working on Longhorn, you could say they got a little too excited. They wanted to make it revolutionary instead of evolutionary, and they didn't want to wait until Blackcomb to do it. This then caused Longhorn to be pushed back as well, now with a release scheduled for 2003. Features that were initially reserved for Blackcomb were now being added on to Longhorn. Discussion of the OS within the tech press created quite a bit of anticipation for what it may look like. So it didn't take long for some of the first builds of the program to leak in around 2002. Because it was so early on in its development, this design really didn't look all that different from XP, but it was a clear enough indication of what type of vision Microsoft was going for. A whole new touched-up design that they called Plex, boasting a beautiful, rustic landscape. Although it still had a way to go, this was going to be Microsoft's response to Apple's Aqua design, and it was going to be pure eye candy. The digital world had just gotten so much warmer and cleaner than ever, and Longhorn was going to be the one to take you there. Oh, look at me, I'm in a square space. I know, this was the part of the video you were most excited about, but sadly, I gotta keep it short. Did you know that Squarespace easily allows you to design your own professional website all in one place? It makes this remarkably simple thanks to something called design intelligence. You don't need to be a computer whiz to create a gorgeous website. Instead, Squarespace will do all the heavy lifting for you. By combining two decades of industry-standard design trends and taking your needs into account, it will provide a template tailored just for you, which you can then further customize yourself. You can even use Squarespace payments to set up a payment portal to sell your own products, which supports Apple Pay, Klarna, debit card, and a variety of other ways. It's such intuitive software. Like huzzah! Nine Inch Nails? I hardly know her. Counting Crows? Nah, I prefer Counting Sheep when I go to bed. Much less intimidating. Cease and Desist from Universal Music Group. These band names are really getting creative. When your website is ready to go online, just connect it with your Squarespace domain, and now you're live to the world! And you can get started on your website today. Head to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready, head to squarespace.com/nationsquid to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain name. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. These leaks did show that Longhorn was on its way to having quite a bit of potential. Each subsequent leak that showed up over time proved to be more promising and slicker than the last one. Microsoft even created some video demos for the product, including these flashy animations, effects, complemented with contemporary music that very much matched the tone of the operating system. Windows XP was just archaic in comparison. It was clear that this was what the 2000s was supposed to look like, and Microsoft was ready to be the frontrunner, or so they thought. While a demo like this sure looks incredible, especially for its time, it is none other than the byproduct of Microsoft adding on all these features to a version of Windows originally intended to just be an incremental update. This sometimes can be a good idea, but only when you have a structured, concrete plan to go with it. And during this stage of development, Microsoft was trying to subjectively figure out what constituted a small feature that would be suitable for Longhorn and a large, ambitious feature that would be better for Blackcomb. As you could have guessed, they quickly lost track of this without a transparent vision. This is a practice known as feature creep, and it was one of the first problems that appeared within the Longhorn project. Other than this iconic 3D design, what else did Longhorn include? One of the most notable, more under-the-hood features was something called Windows Future Storage, or WinFS. It was a whole new way of organizing your files, designed to make it orders of magnitude easier, a feature which would greatly complement the simplistic design of the operating system. Rather than just organizing files based on folders and directories, it could essentially categorize files based on their specific attributes and what they have in common with other files on the computer. Say you are working on a class project about the life of Abraham Lincoln. This management system could scrape metadata for the term Abraham Lincoln if you search for it on your computer, so that it could also find your Word document for the project, your PowerPoint presentation, etc. But of course, this was only a small part of how WinFS worked, as it was pretty much meant to be an entirely new way of organizing data on Windows. As you'd expect, that is a very big, complicated task to complete, so naturally, Microsoft needed more time to complete it. This caused Longhorn's release date to be pushed back once again to 2005. This eventually manifested other problems. Because they were spending more time on developing WinFS, they weren't focusing as much on other aspects of the OS. Another feature that was added to Longhorn was called Avalon, and it allowed for the creation and execution of these incredible reflective 3D graphics, which graduated from the Plex design and was now marketed by Microsoft as Aero. But as you could imagine, a new system that often required indexing tons of information in real time, running alongside this intensive Avalon software on early 2000s hardware, was a recipe for disaster. Performance was slow, the code base was bloated and full of bugs because the developers didn't have enough time to refine it. To add insult to injury, this was also during the time of the Blaster computer worm, which predominantly targeted Windows XP machines, and so Microsoft had to move its top engineers over to the development of Windows XP Service Pack 2 so that these issues could be resolved, leaving a lot of these less experienced developers without much direction. In fact, this sentiment poured over into every team that was working on the Longhorn project. To the outside world, all they saw was an operating system that kept getting delayed and saw no progress that was actually realistic for a capable digital environment. So, by 2004, Microsoft was given no other choice but to completely start Longhorn over. They wanted to keep things forward-thinking, but realized that they had to keep it much more simplified. They hinted at adding even other features, such as touchscreen support, which is quite impressive given that this was before the iPhone was released and significantly popularized that technology. But in truth, Longhorn just had the plug pulled on it entirely. Because it had now been almost 5 years since a major release of Windows, they now felt more rushed than ever before to get something out. So, we got Windows Vista in 2006, which has since become one of Microsoft's most controversial products. The rest is history. By focusing so much on creating the best and most feature-packed product, Microsoft lost touch of what their target audience really wanted back in the 2000s. They just wanted something that worked, that was simple to use on their simple machines. Its vision was too advanced for the technology it was designed for. Microsoft biting off more than they could chew and working under this pressure and these time constraints increased their chances of making a less than capable operating system and a lot of empty promises. And unfortunately, that's what ended up happening. Rather than being revolutionary or even evolutionary, Longhorn just became forgotten history. Though hopefully, through learning more about it, we can learn more about the limitations of computers as well as ourselves, and how we can use that to make better decisions going forward. I mean, could you imagine someone rushing something just to meet a business deadline? I couldn't. What day is it again? A few years ago, I made a video detailing much of Windows Vista's story and the legacy it had after Longhorn, which you can check out here. A special thanks to all my Patreon supporters down below, patreon.com/nationsquid. You can always buy me a coffee too. Thank you for watching, everyone.